Hello friends, in this video I am going to show you how to calculate reactions transmitted to the walls for the steelwork arrangement. So you can see the problem here. It says find the beam loads and the reactions transmitted to the walls for the steelwork arrangement shown in figure using this design data. You can see design data here, reinforced concrete slab thickness, street weight, imposed load on slabs, mass of steel beams, and other than that, there is additional data which are unit weight of concrete and acceleration due to gravity of earth. So this is the steelwork arrangement. So let's see how we calculate the reactions transmitted to the walls for this steelwork arrangement. Let's we start the calculation. First step is to find in concrete slab self weight. So it can be calculated using this. So here point one is the slab thickness. So slab thickness is 100 millimeters. We can convert into meters. So we get 0.1. Then times 25. 25 is the unit weight of concrete. So then we can get concrete slab self weight as 2.5. Then steel beam self weight. This 80 is the mass of steel beams. This 9.81 is the acceleration due to gravity of earth. And this 1000 is used for unit conversions. So we need this answer as kilonewton per meter. For that we have to use this 1000 for unit conversion purposes. So then we can get steel beam self weight as 0.78 kilonewton per meters. First we will consider beam A. So you can see beam A in this figure. Before we start our calculation, we have to know how the loads are transferred. So in this beam A, weight of this shaded area will be transferred to the beam A. How can I say that? For that, there is a theory. Have you ever heard of one-way slab and two-way slab? So I will show you what is the one-way slab and what is the two-way slab. In one-way slabs, load is transferred to only one direction. You can see this is the breadth of the slab and this is half of the breadth and this is also half of the breadth. So this load is, half of the load is transferred to this beam, this half of the load is transferred to this beam. Two-way slab is, load is transferred to two directions or two ways. So in this system, all four beams will get the loads. So this is the requirement for determining the one-way slab or two-way slab. So you can see here at slab panel, this is the length of the slab. This is the breadth of the slab. So we can say it is a one-way slab when L over B ratio equal or greater than 2. We can say it is a two-way slab if L over B ratio less than 2. So now you know what is the one-way slab and two-way slab. Here you can see notation. This notation means this is a one-way slab, right? Okay, as I said before, load of this shaded area will be transferred to beam A. How we calculate the area of this shaded area? So as you know, this is a one-way slab. You can calculate it. It's simple calculation. So this is the length of the slab. So it is 5 and it's divided by breadth of the slab. So this slab breadth is 2.5. So when we simplify it, we can get 5 over 2.5, which is 2, which means L over B ratio equals to 2. That means this is a one-way slab. This is also a one-way slab. Okay then, how we calculate the area of this shaded area. So this length is 1.25, because this whole length is 2.5, half of the 2.5 is 1.25, and also this length is 1.25. again, this whole length is 2.5, half of this is 1.25. so now we know the area of this shaded area, because 1.25 plus 1.25 means 2.5 meters, and this is the length, it is given, it's 5. So we can easily calculate 5 times 2.5 is the area of this shaded area. And when we consider the beam, you can see load is acted as UDL beam, which means uniformly distributed load. So next we will see how to calculate this UDL on beam. First one is street weight. So here this one is the street weight, it is given in the data, and this 5 times 2.5 is the area of the shaded area. When you simplify it, we can get 12.5 kilonewtons. Then concrete slab. This 2.5 is the concrete slab self weight. It is calculated before. And again, 5 times 2.5 is the area of shaded area. So then we can get 31.3 kilonewtons. Then steel beam, this 0.78 is the steel beam self weight. This is also we calculated before, and this 5 is the length of the beam. So you can see here 5 meters, and then we can get 3.9 kilonewtons. So those are the dead loads. Then we have to calculate imposed loads. Here you can see imposed load, this 3 is the imposed load on slabs, it's given in the data, and 5 times 2.5 is the area of shaded area. So then we can get imposed load as 37.5 kilonewtons. Then we can sum up all three values, then we can get 47.7 kilonewton as dead loads, and there's only one imposed load, therefore we can say imposed load value is 37.5 kilonewtons. Next we have to find total uniformly distributed load for serviceability limit states. So how we find this serviceability limit states? So you can see a box here. So this is the formula for verifying serviceability limit states. It says 1.gk plus 1.qk is equals to serviceability limit state. So GK means the total dead load, and QK means the total imposed load. So 1.GK means just GK, and here also 1.QK means just QK. So in order to find serviceability limit state, we have to sum up these values, which are GK plus QK. So total dead load GK, total dead load is equal to this value 47.7 kilonewton, and total imposed load value is equals to 37.5 kilonewton. So here you can see those values, 47.7 plus 37.5. So when you simplify it, you can get 85.2. this is the total UD for serviceability limit states. Next we have to find total UD load for ultimate limit states. For ultimate limit states also there is a formula. Here you can see 1.35 GK plus 1.5 QK. again, GK is the total dead load, and QK is the total imposed load. This time we have to multiply GK value by 1.35. So in order to find total UD load for ultimate limit state, we have to multiply 1.35 with GK. GK means the total dead load. Total dead load we calculated, it is 47.7, and 1.5 QK. So you have to calculate this value by 1.5 times QK. QK is the total imposed load, we calculated that as 37.5. So when we simplify it, we can get total UD load for ultimate limit states is 120.6 kilonewton. Okay, now we can draw the free body diagram. You can see there are two supports, and this is the beam, which is beam A, and this is the UD load. Now we are going to write load values. So UD loads, there are two loads. First one is serviceability limit states. So you can see SCRV, this is this means serviceability limit state. That value is 85.2. Then ULT, ULT means ultimate limit states. ULT value is 120.6 kilonewtons. So that is wrote here. Then we have to find support reactions. How we find support reactions? This 42.6 came from 85.2, which is this value divided by 2. Then we can get 42.6 kilonewtons, and this value is also the same, it came from the same procedure. Then 60.3, how we get 60.3? When 120.6, which is this ultimate value, is divided by 2, we can get 60.3, and here also it is same. That's how we calculate the support reactions for beam A. Next we have to consider beam B. As I said before, these slabs, there is a one slab and there is another slab. These slabs are one way slabs, so which means loads are transferred only one way. So this shaded area load will be bared by beam A. Then there is a rest of beam, right? This beam load is transferred to this hole, and also a load of this area will be transferred to this hole. Then from beam, there are no loads acted on beam B, but there are loads on beam B, which are self weight of the beam B. Beam B is a steel beam, so that beam has a weight itself. Other than self weight, there is another load. So we will see what is that load. So for your convenience, I draw a picture here. This is beam A, so which is this beam, and you can see two beams there, and these two beams are beam B. So this beam A is on the beam B, right? So you can see there is a load transferred to beam B. When we see beam B alone, we can see this reaction or this load as a point load. So you can see the beam B picture here. So this is the distributor load. This distributor load is the distribution load due to self weight of the beam. And this point load is the point load due to beam A. Remember, in beam A there are support reactions. So those support reactions is transferred to this beam B. So we can see that support reaction as a point load when we comes to beam B. Now we can find the UD loads on beam B. Self weight due to steel beam, here 0.78 means the steel beam self weight calculated before, and this 5 is the length of the beam, it's given in the problem. So you can see beam B length here 2.5 plus 2.5 is 5 meters. Okay, this is the only UD beam on the beam B, so we can get as 3.9 kilonewtons. Same as before, now we have to find the total UD load for serviceability limit state as well as the total UD load for ultimate limit state. So same formula we used before. For verifying serviceability limit states, we can use this formula, GK plus QK. So GK is the total dead load and QK is the imposed load. In this case, there are no imposed loads. Therefore, we have to use only dead load value. So here imposed load part is not applicable. GK equals 3.9 kilonewton. 1 times GK is the 3.9 kilonewtons, and total UD load for serviceability limit state is equals to 3.9 kilonewtons. Total UD load for ultimate limit state, which is 1.35 times GK. So there are no imposed load now, therefore we don't have to consider about this QK. 1.35 times GK, GK is equals again 3.9 kilonewtons. So we can get total UD load for ultimate limit state equals 3.9 times 1.35, which is equals to 5.3 kilonewtons. Now I can draw the diagram for beam B as well. The diagram below shows the loads on beam B and the reaction transmitted to the walls. So next we will see how these values came. So this is the beam A isolated. I put it there for your convenience. Here point load is equals to 42.6 kilonewton serviceability. So it is came from the beam A. You can see beam A support reaction is for the serviceability limit state is 42.6. So it is go to as point load in this beam B. And also in this beam A, support reaction for ultimate limit state is 60.3 kilonewton. It is directly go to beam B as a point load. Next, we will see how these reactions came. So 23.3 came from 42.6 plus 3.9, which are 42.6 is the this point load for serviceability limit state, and 3.9 is the UD load serviceability limit state value. So we have to get the sum of these values and divided by 2, we can get the support reaction for serviceability limit state. Then 32.8. So 60.3 is the point load for ultimate limit state, and 5.3 is the UD load for ultimate limit state. So we have to sum up those values and divide by 2, we can get support reaction for ultimate limit state. That's how we calculate the support reaction for this steel beam arrangement. I hope you understand the lesson. So if you get anything or if you learn anything from this video, please do subscribe our YouTube channel and give us a support. And please like the video and please leave a comment and share this video with your friends. Thank you.